गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ वीरपाल कौर। टुडे आई विल टीच यू चैप्टर 1 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन व्हाई एंड हाउ। आई विल टीच दिस चैप्टर फॉर क्लास प्लस 1 पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया। लेट्स स्टार्ट इट नाउ स्टूडेंट्स। वी विल डू टॉक अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। A constitution is a written set of laws and fundamental principles to develop a relationship between the people and the government, which comprises a number of articles above the. Now, students, firstly, we shall see why do we need a constitution. First is to provide a set of basic rules to allow for minimal coordination among the members of a society. Secondly, it is used to specify how the government would be constituted and who has the power to make decision in the society. Next work of constitution is to lay some limitations on government's power by granting right to the citizens. Fourth is to enable the government to fulfill its aspirations of a society and create coordination for just society. And last one is to express the fundamental identity of people. The Constitution of India was framed by the Constituent Assembly between December 1946 and November 1949. Constitutions are often subverted, not by the people, but by small groups who wish to enhance their own power. Well-crafted constitutional fragment far in a society intelligently so that no single group can subvert the constitution. The Indian constitution horizontally executive and judiciary and even independent statutory like bodies, the election commission and intelligent system of checks and balances facilitated the success of Indian constitution. The constitution assembly spent 2 years, 11 months, 18 days to prepare the constitution to be adopted on November 26, 1949 and came into force on 26 January 1950s. The Constitution Assembly had 8 major committees on different subjects. Usually Jawaharlal Nehru, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Patel or Dr. B.R. Ambedkar chaired these committees. Each committee usually drafted particular provision of the constitution which were then subjected to debate by the entire assembly. The Constitution of India is the supreme law to be accepted and respected by all the citizens as well as the institutions of the country. Only one provision of the constitution was passed without victory and it debate: the introduction of universal suffrage. Universal suffrage means all citizens reaching a certain age would be entitled to be voters irrespective of religion, caste, education, gender or income. The Constitution of India is a blend of flexibility and rigidity as it is federal in form but united in spirit. The main federal feature of Indian constitution are written and flexible constitution, distribution of power between the center and state, supremacy of judiciary and existence of bicameral legislature. The framers of Indian constitution have borrowed a number of provisions as per the suitability of the nation from different countries like the British Constitution, the American Constitution, the Constitution of Canada, the Constitution of Ireland, the Constitution of France, etc., along with the Government of India Act 1934.